We've learned all about how and why you should use segmentation in your marketing and sales. Now, let's take a tour of the Segment Builder. The Segment Builder appears in several places in the ActiveCampaign platform. We'll start with the most basic by looking at contacts. You'll see a Search Contacts field in the upper right. Click in the box to use the advanced search. Ta-da! Here's the Segment Builder. It may not look exciting yet, but let's click around a bit. Click on the Select a Condition field. There are several categories we can search for, including contact details, custom fields, the actions a contact has taken, and more. Let's start with contact details and find customers with a specific tag. Now we have to specify if we are looking for contacts with a specific tag or if we are looking for contacts without that tag. In other words, does this tag exist or not exist? We'll pick exists. Now the final field has been pre-populated with all of the tags in this account. We have a tag for customer. Let's select that. So, now we are using the Segment Builder to search for all contacts who have the tag customer. We can add another condition to this search as well by clicking Add Another Condition. When adding a condition, you can select and, or. Selecting and will help you find contacts that meet all of your criteria. Selecting or will help you find contacts that match either criteria. Let's select anyone who has opened a recent campaign. Click on Select a Condition, go to Actions, and click Has Opened. Then click the drop-down to find a campaign. This segment will include all of your customers who opened this particular campaign. Adding a new segment group will allow you to add an entirely new segment of people to your search with an and or an or. But for now, we'll delete this group and click Search. Now we can see all of our contacts that have the tag customer who have opened a particular campaign. Perhaps you'd like to use this segment in other places. Simply click on the search box again where it says two conditions set. Our segment builder will pop up again and we have two new options, save as segment and save as search. If we click on save as segment, we will be able to name this segment and use it throughout the platform, such as your next campaign send. We'll call this Customer Opened Campaign. However, if you just want to be able to use this search again, you can click Save as Search. You can name your search as well. We'll call this Customers to Watch. These segments are dynamic. This means you are saving the search conditions, and the contacts will be added and removed from the segment based on their current status. After you save your search, you will be redirected to the contacts page. Clicking on the search field again will now show both advanced searched and saved searches. Clicking on the saved searches will show anything you've already saved. You can delete them by clicking the X or check out your search by clicking the title. Let's go back to the home screen. The Segment Builder exists in multiple locations within the ActiveCampaign platform. This includes lists, where you can refine a larger group of contacts. Click on the down caret to the right of a list and click on Segments. This will show you the segments that have been created and include members of a list. Clicking on a list will bring you to that list of contacts, where you can also create a new segment. Click on Search Contacts to begin. Another quick note, segment conditions will pull all contacts from an account, regardless of their list association, even if you're accessing a segment from a list. Okay, let's go back to the home screen. Next, we can create a segment when sending a campaign. Click on Campaigns to start. Now we'll click on New Campaign. We'll enter a title for this campaign. Let's call this Segment Test for now. We'll stick with a standard campaign. Click Next. You'll now see all of your lists. We'll select our announcements and news list. As soon as you select a list, you'll see the option to segment selected lists, both on the top and the bottom of the screen. Here, you can select a segment you've already created from the dropdown. You can also create a new segment for this campaign. Click on Create New Segment. You'll be asked to title your segment. We'll title this Testing. Then, click Add Your First Condition. We can create a segment, and then we would select Done to use this in our campaign. For now, we'll go back to the home screen. Finally, we can create and use segments in automations. You can create segments while you're setting your automation triggers. Let's create a new automation by clicking the New Automation button. We'll select the Start from Scratch option. Click Continue. Now, you can select any start trigger you would like, and you will have the option to segment who is allowed to enter this automation. Let's select Submits a Form. Click Continue. Here we have our normal start triggers for a form, but let's check out the advanced option on the bottom of the modal. Click the Segment checkbox. By using this option, you are creating a segment so that only the contacts who match the trigger and segment conditions will enter the automation. Let's say we only want contacts who have opened any email to enter this automation. Click Select a Condition. Select Actions. Select Has Opened. We'll leave this as any campaign or email and click Add Start to finish our trigger. You'll also find the Segment Builder when you're creating automation actions. Let's click on the plus to add an action. Go to the Conditions and Workflow menu. We'll create an if-else in our automation. As soon as you select that split, you'll be in a Segment Builder again. Now we want to send different emails based on a tag. Click on Select a Condition, and then Contact Details. Then scroll to Tag. We'll split this segment based on if they have a tag that indicates that they've received a 10% discount, so we don't oversend the same sale. Click OK. This automation is using the power of segmentation to really personalize the customer journey.
The more comfortable you become with the Segment Builder, the more targeted you can be in your marketing and sales automation. We've included plenty of resources with this course to help you further explore and understand the options in the Segment Builder. But we encourage you to play around, pull in more data, test different sends, and see what works best for you.